If you had one word to describe Texas whiskey, what would it be?
Open-minded. And that's a hyphenated word, so I think that counts as one word.
Yeah.
It might be a little corny, but I would say cornucopia.
I'll describe it as bold.
Explosive. Experiential.
Independence.
Big.
Bold.
Intense. I'm just gonna go with intense.
Texas whiskey is just flat out Texan.
It's right. Texas.
Bold. Unquestionable. Texas whiskey is bold. If you ask that question to anyone and they don't say the word bold, then they haven't tried Texas whiskey.
Wait till you see the episode. I think you'll like it. So,
Texas, home of the Longhorn, the Alamo, Riverwalk, barbecue, and now whiskey. Since bursting onto the scene a little over a decade ago, Texas whiskey has been gaining respect around the world. So I went down to find out what makes their whiskey so special. When I got there, my initial thought was Texas and whiskey would be a marriage that goes back centuries. But what I found was quite the contrary.
Tell me about the Texas whiskey history.
So the Texas whiskey history is a very youthful history because of, you know, media culture and cowboy movies. Everybody just kind of assumes that Texas and whiskey have always been hand in hand, but they really haven't. It's around that time of the Wild West, whiskey was coming from lots of different places, right? It was coming from Kentucky, it was coming from Tennessee, it was coming from Pennsylvania. So it may be part of the mindset of a lot of people thinking that Texas and whiskey go together, but they didn't really until the late 2000s. From the very onset of the Texas whiskey industry, there was competition. And it was Garrison Brothers Distillery that was actually the first legal bourbon whiskey distillery in Texas since Prohibition. And then Balcones was right there after them. They, you know, I think Garrison Brothers had the first DSP. Balcones was right after them, and then Balcones released a whiskey prior to Garrison releasing their bourbon. So that competition was right there from the beginning. Everybody that is a whiskey maker in Texas is extremely proud of what they do. And, you know, like a lot of Texans, they always want to be the first, the best. And I think that accelerated the quality of Texas whiskey because everybody started competing with each other immediately.
Yeah, we're just now old enough where if we were in Scotland, we would be releasing our first entry-level spirit at a 12-year age statement.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
And that's insane.
That is.
But we've been, for 12 years, winning world awards, winning Master Distiller of the Year, beating Scotland at its game, beating Kentucky at its game.
How does Texas whiskey compare to other whiskey regions around the world?
Right, so if you think of all the impacts that impact the flavor of whiskey, a lot of different countries use the same grains, other states use the same mash, you know, relative mash bills or high corn. And so I would say that arguably the biggest difference between Texas whiskey and every other whiskey, no matter the style that's being made, is, sounds weird to say it, but it's Texas. Texas is the difference. And it's not this attitude that we all have. It's the state of Texas is that different.
Texas is huge. It's a very big state. And there are distinct climatological regions in the state. And so, you know, we're east of the Rockies, but all those cold fronts kind of hug the Rockies as they come down the Great Plains, and they filter all the way down through Texas, right?
And keep in mind that North Texas is basically the south end of the Yukon. As far as temperature goes, right? Because what can happen is a cold front comes out of Yukon and it goes south. There's nothing to stop it until Dallas.
Yes.
Right? And so one day you'll be 85, 90 degrees, and then all of a sudden a true cold front comes through and it drops into single digits 2 days later and everything ices over, right? Because there's just nothing there.
So we have a very significant change in temperature variation all year round, except in the summer. And then in the summer, the Gulf Coast pressure kind of builds up. You have these high pressure domes that sit, and we have these intense killer summers that can last 72 days of 100 degree temperatures, right?
you know, above a certain temperature, whiskey pushes into the wood. Mm-hmm. And under a certain temperature, it pushes out of the wood.
Right.
Like a sponge. Gotcha. And that's how whiskey ages. Mm-hmm. Right. One of the ways. Well, in Scotland, you may get that give and take X amount of times in a year. Mm-hmm. In Texas, you're going to get that anywhere from 10 to 50 times as many back and forths in the same year. And that's even with full-size barrels, right? Right.
And that's really the main problem with Texas whiskey, is that when you're maturing a whiskey, you've got oxidation that happens in the barrel, right? You have chemical reactions like esterification, where different compounds that are in the whiskey are combining to create new flavor compounds. And then you have extraction, where the whiskey's moving in and out of the wood and it's pulling things out of that wood. And in Texas, we have massive amounts of extraction because we have huge temperature swings, way more than you have further up north in Kentucky or even Tennessee. But if you leave it in the barrel long enough for it to go through those other processes and get enough oxidation and have time for esterification, then you get too much extraction. And so that's the battle that's being faced, the distillers trying to fight against the climate.
And so everyone else in the world is trying to figure out how to make whiskey get done quicker. In Texas, we're trying to figure out how to buy time.
Wow.
And keep it in the barrel longer.
Wow.
Because what happens to us is with new oak and used oak, that barrel impact happens so quick here. Yeah. That we're like, no, it's only two. We're not ready yet.
Right.
Yeah.
Whiskey has been known as time is the thing that matters most. Everybody's like, well, is it a 25-year-old? Is it a 12-year-old? What is it? In Texas, it's talent. The talent is what matters. And it's the talent of the distillers to be checking the barrels daily and seeing what it did the night before after the cold front pushed through. See what it did after we have a day like today when it's 107. You know, you have to be talented to know when to pull it, when to make that call.
And it's because of that talent that Texas whiskey is flourishing. After winning numerous awards, the industry has already taken notice that pioneering distilleries and the terroir of Texas are pushing the boundaries of what whiskey can be.
I mean, you've seen the start
right to
now. Did you think, like when it first started, that you know, Texas whiskey would have had this success?
No, absolutely not. I remember the first time I tried Texas whiskey ever. Mm-hmm. And so at the time, I just thought, like, this is young, this is raw, this is almost brutal.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. And this is cool, but it's not going to replace my scotch drinking anytime soon.
Gotcha.
Right?
Gotcha.
Yeah. I do not feel that way now. There's more Texas whiskey in my cabinet than anything but scotch, and I regularly drink just that.
Yeah.
There's just the diversity is astonishing, and the things that people have arrived at now, it's amazing.
What is interesting to me is the world is starting to come to terms with the fact that Texas whiskey is a thing. Because of the heirloom varietals that they use of corn here in Texas when they're making bourbon and some of the other processes that they use, the intensity of flavor is much higher in Texas than it is in Kentucky. And when you try to follow the Kentucky playbook here in Texas, it produces a very different result.
There's a lot of people in our club alone who are still trying to, no matter that they live in Texas or not, are still trying to understand if they like Texas whiskey, because so many of us just grew up not knowing what Texas whiskey was. And so many of them are having to transition from Kentucky bourbon. And so most of them want to taste something that tastes like Kentucky bourbon. And really, most Texas whiskeys don't.
There's the Kentucky bourbon drinker who just likes really good entry-level 40-proof Kentucky bourbon, right? Those people, when they come to Texas, it's a lot of like, oh, I'm needing some ice. Can we have some ice for it? Or it's like, whoa, right? Or it's a whole new world. Wow, this is amazing. This is totally different. This is amazing, right? Yeah. But then there's your Kentucky bourbon drinkers who are serious about cask strength and going after the Stag Junior, and they don't mind a high proof bourbon. And those guys come down to Texas and fall in love instantly. They either show up and they're like, wow, I'm not ready for this. Mm-hmm. I need a mixer. Yeah. Or they show up and go, why didn't someone tell me that whiskey could taste like this?
If you had one word to describe Texas whiskey, what would it be? I've heard some interesting
intense
stuff.
I'm just gonna go with intense.
Bold, unquestionable. Texas whiskey is bold.
Explosive.
Explosive, yeah.
I feel like that's, you know, I hear the words, you know, robust and things like, and richness, and those are great, great terms. I use those with every whiskey. Yeah. Explosive though, you don't hear that often. And I feel like that's what you're getting with a lot of these Texas whiskeys, you know.
What is the identity of Texas whiskey, in your opinion?
The identity of Texas whiskey is still being discovered. And each distillery is kind of finding its own way. Everybody had to kind of develop their own style, figure out what works here. There's so many variables that go into how you make whiskey. And those variables obviously affect its flavor. And people had to make a lot of mistakes before they could figure out, this is something that we want to pursue, this flavor, this style. There's so much innovation and development happening that even in a year, year and a half, you're gonna taste something that's completely different. And I tell people, if you have tried a Texas whiskey and you didn't like it, and it's been more than 6 months, you gotta try again. Because that's how fast the innovation is taking place in the Texas whiskey scene.
And that's really exciting to me because a lot of these distilleries, they're not afraid to experiment. They're not afraid to just try an innovative approach to coming up with what the flavor profiles are going to be. They don't go by expectations. Like, this rye, we expect it to taste this way. This bourbon should have this kind of flavor profile. The creativity is just limitless.
If you want to do something, the answer has been yes. And I think that is the single number one thing that has caused Texas whiskey to explode has been, yes, let's do it. These young, innovative minds that are willing to think outside the box and listen to the consumer is something that currently is exclusive to Texas.
You can taste whiskey from all over the world, if you will, just right here because of the techniques and the experimentation that's going on right now due to our newness.
What are the next steps you see in kind of, you know, from continued innovation or what from Texas whiskey?
You know, it's crazy because I don't know, I almost don't know what to say because these guys are blowing my mind with the innovation they're doing right now. They never cease to amaze me. So these guys are in the business for a reason. And I know they'll continue to surprise me beyond ways that I could never imagine. Yeah. Everyone's experimenting. Everyone's trying something new and unique. And there's a sense of lawlessness here. It truly is the Wild West.
It's exciting to watch the growth of Texas whiskey. The fearlessness to innovate, the amazing talent, and big, bold flavors match the character of the state itself. I know I'll be back soon to learn more about Texas whiskey and see what they're up to next. One thing I know for sure, Texas whiskey is here to stay.
You have to stop expecting Texas whiskey to taste like Kentucky. We don't expect Indian whiskey to taste like Scotch or Japanese whiskey to taste like Scotch. Texas doesn't give a fuck about it tasting like bourbon or Kentucky bourbon. We just want to make good spirits and we want to do it our own way.